continue with our series. Our last video, we are making this main form for mini store database. We put some add item, then the item list also. However, if we will check here in item, if we will enter duplicates item number, is it possible also without notification? So we need to restrict for that issue. Okay, now let's start. Here, so we will put some code after entering our item number. This should be a message box pop up that inform us that this particular item number has already been entered. Okay, let's start. We'll close this one. Then design view. Now here, this item number. So we will just put or rename txt item number. Now we'll select this one, go to event, then before update. So before update, that particular message box should become to avoid any duplicate item number. Like here, this is our item number. Then if we will type one of this item number, it should be notify us that we enter a duplicate item number. Okay, here we'll put first on error, then resume next. Now we'll use decount. If decount open parenthesis, then we'll put double quote, then asterisk, then double quote. We'll put comma, then another double quote. Now we will put our table, which is this one, store items. So store items, then double quote, then comma, again criteria. We'll put some double quote first, then criteria is our item number, which is this one, our field, this one, item number. Here, item number, then equal, then we'll put single quote, then followed by double quote, then and our text box. So we mean that txt item number, that value is one, and again we put double quote, then another single quote, and again our field, which is item number, equal single quote, then double quote. Then and me again are TXT number or text box. That value value, then we'll put and again double quote, single quote and double quote. Now we will close, so meaning I will put more than zero, so it will shows that this whole particular item number is duplicates. So we'll put the message box here, message box that this item number has already been entered. Then please try another item number. Then we'll put some we'll use information that will pop up. Then our form option, which is duplicate item number here, then we will put a cursor into our item number here that set focus, then cancel equal true. Okay, this code will prevent us to enter duplicate item number. Okay, now we'll open this one just to show them. Now we will copy this one. Look, if I enter this one, then I will hit tab lock, duplicate item number. This item number has already been entered. Please try another item. Look, if I enter also 2 here, tab lock, this item number again is already been entered. If I will type 12 lock, so the system will accept item number. So water surprise 12, so you can enter. Then we will save, then close again. If I copy this one, then add new lock again, it will prevent us to enter and duplicate. So this is it. This is how to prevent duplicate entries. Thank you and God bless.